Today we had part two of quote unquote Black History Month. So today we're gonna give a lesson called When We Were Kings. Because people have you think that back in the days of our captivity that they were coming to our land and taking us into captivity, running through the jungles, being savages and things like that. Not telling the truth about where we came from, because we built one of the seven wonders of the world, which is the temple that the Lord had in Jerusalem. So they made it think like we couldn't read, we couldn't write, we couldn't do nothing, so that they had to bring us to the Americas or across the world to give us, to civilize them. Today we're going to go through the Bible and show what Israel had as a nation, as a people, before the curses came upon us because of what we did against our God. So I just want to show you that to show you what we gave up as a people. Because I even thought about it, we had opportunity to be kings over the whole world, and we blew the mission. We had the God of Israel with us, and while we had good laws, good statutes, and commandments, and we blew the mission. So, you know, as much as I complain about the government that we're in right now, we had a better government, and we blew the mission. So I can't complain. I thought about that. I said, you know what? I got to look at my history and see how bad of leaders we were and not complain about what condition we are in today. So we're going to look at that today, because bottom line is we have to know our roots, know where we came from, know what we did, and know where we at when it comes to the Lord as a chosen people. Okay? So we're going to start this off in Genesis, the 35th chapter. Genesis 35. And we're going to pick it up at verse 9. Genesis 35 and verse 9. Go ahead.
And God appeared unto Jacob again when he came out of Paddan Aram and blessed him. Mm-hmm. And God said unto him, thy name is Jacob. Mm-hmm. Thy name shall not be called any more Jacob, uh-huh. but Israel shall be thy name. Uh-huh. And he called his name Israel. Mm-hmm. And God said unto him, I am God Almighty. Mm-hmm. Be fruitful and multiply. Uh-huh. A nation and a company of nations shall be of thee. Mm-hmm. And kings shall come out of thy loins.
Now, what did he tell Jacob? Kings was going to come out of his loins. Which means out of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel, we were going to have kings. Okay, go ahead.
In the land which I gave Abraham and Isaac, mm-hmm. to thee I will give it. Uh-huh. And to thy seed after thee will I give the land.
So now, and he gave us the promises, right? To give his seed, the children of Israel, the promised land. Once they got that promised land, they were the controllers of that promised land. Okay? Now, let's go to Exodus, the 6th chapter. We're going to walk this thing up from the past all the way to the present day. Exodus 6 and verse 6. Go ahead.
Wherefore, say unto the children of Israel, mm-hmm. I am the Lord, uh-huh. and I will bring you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians, mm-hmm. and I will rid you out of their bondage, mm-hmm. and I will redeem you with the stretched out arm, mm-hmm. and with great judgment, uh-huh. and I will take you to me for a people, and I will be to you a God, mm-hmm. and ye shall know that I am the Lord your God, mm-hmm. which bringeth you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians.
Go ahead.
And I will bring you in unto the land, mm-hmm. concerning the which I did swear to give it to Abraham, mm-hmm. to Isaac, and to Jacob, mm-hmm. and I will give it you for a heritage, mm-hmm. I am the Lord.
So now, did it ever pass down to Ishmael? No. Did it ever pass down to Esau?
No.
Only to the children of Israel. Okay, now, go to Exodus the 11th chapter, and we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Exodus 11 and verse 1. Go ahead.
And the Lord said unto Moses, mm-hmm. yet will I bring one plague more upon Pharaoh, mm-hmm. and upon Egypt.
Now this last plague was when he's going to kill all the firstborn in Egypt. Okay, go ahead.
Afterwards, he will let you go hence. Mm-hmm. When he shall let you go, he shall surely thrust you out hence altogether. Mm-hmm. Speak now in the ears of the people, uh-huh. and let every man borrow of his neighbor, mm-hmm. and every woman of her neighbor, uh-huh. jewels of silver, mm-hmm. and jewels of gold.
Now, why did the Lord set that up? Because he told Abraham, your seed was going to be in captivity for 400 years, but they was going to come out with great suffering. Same thing now. The Lord is making that come to happen, because he's telling the children of Israel, borrow from your neighbor. Who's their neighbor? The Egyptians. And he said, get gold and silver. And they took other things too, but the main thing they took was gold and silver. Okay? Now, go to the 12th chapter and pick it up in verse 30. 12 and verse 30. Go ahead.
And Pharaoh rose up in the night, he and all his servants and all the Egyptians. And there was a great cry in Egypt, for there was not a house where there was not one dead.
Now, because Moses did all, brought all these things upon Pharaoh through the hand of the Lord. The last one he had, the firstborn Egyptian killed, or everybody that was in that land, even the animal. But bottom line is, now Pharaoh ready to get rid of him. Okay, go ahead.
And he called for Moses and Aaron by night and said, rise up and get you forth from among my people, both ye and the children of Israel, and go. Serve the Lord, as ye have said. Also take your flocks and your herds, as ye have said, and be gone, and bless me also.
First he said, well, you ain't taking nothing, right? Now he said, take your flocks and your herds and do what? Bless me also. It took him almost 10 plagues to him to say, okay, your God is God. But the Lord hardened his heart, so because he wanted to do this thing on Egypt anyway. Okay, go ahead.
And the Egyptians were urging upon the people that they might send them out of the land in haste. For they said, we be all dead men.
Now they know, because the Lord showed them example. Look, I take all your firstborn. If y'all don't get right, I'll kill every last one of y'all. So they said, look, get them Israelites out of here. Okay, go ahead.
And the people took their dough before it was leavened, their kneading troughs being bound up in their clothes upon their shoulders. And the children of Israel did according to the word of Moses, and they borrowed of the Egyptians jewels of silver and jewels of gold and raiment.
Now, you know, the Egyptians, they were so scared of them, they said, look, take what you want. You want that big old piece of gold, chunk of gold on the wall, take it. You want that little earring, take it. And that's what the children of Israel did. Okay, go ahead.
And the Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, so that they lent unto them such things as they required, and they spoiled the Egyptians.
So now, were they going to bring a payment back? No, they took this and they left with it, right? Plain and simple. Okay, now, let's go to Exodus, the 25th chapter. Exodus 25, Israel said, it's free. Let me have that too. Exodus 25 and verse 1. Go ahead.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, if they bring me an offering. Of every man that giveth it willingly with his heart, ye shall take my offering.
Now, the children of Israel were slaves in Egypt, right? But now the Lord asked them to bring an offering. Where did they get the stuff from? From the Egyptians. Okay, go ahead.
And this is the offering which ye shall take of them, gold and silver and brass.
Now, there's some other things on that list, but we're not going to get into that today, because bottom line is, I just want to show you the wealth that was used in the tabernacle and in the temple. Okay, but bottom line is, all this stuff was used, the material was used for the tabernacle and temple. We're just dealing with the gold and silver today. Okay, now skip down to verse 8.
And let them make me a sanctuary that I may dwell among them, according to all that I show thee, after the pattern of the tabernacle, and the pattern of all the instruments thereof, even so shall ye make it. And they shall make an ark of shittim wood. Two cubits and a half shall be the length thereof, and a cubit and a half the breadth thereof, and a cubit and a half the height thereof. And thou shalt overlay it with pure gold.
Now, what kind of gold?
Pure.
So they leave out with no cheap gold, right? They left out with pure gold. Okay, go ahead.
And within and without shalt thou overlay, and shalt make upon it a crown of gold round about it. And thou shalt cast four rings of gold for it, and put them in the four corners thereof. And two rings shall be in one side of it, and two rings in the other side of it. And thou shalt make staves of shittim wood, and overlay them with gold. And thou shalt put the staves into the rings by the sides of the ark, that the ark may be borne with them.
So now, this is just the ark. And it's overlaid with gold. The sticks that you carry is overlaid with gold. The rings is gold. So all this stuff that the children of Israel got out of Egypt, they was using it to prepare things for the tabernacle that the Lord said, you're going to make the way I want you to make it. Okay? Now go to the 38th chapter of Exodus. Exodus 38. And we're going to pick it up at verse 21. Exodus 38 and verse 21.
You know, I didn't print out the treasures. Did I print it out?
Yes, sir.
I the name's on there, but that's not it.
You did this last time.
It stopped me this morning with this activity. Y'all hold on for a minute, because I got to go print it out. It's on my computer. I got to print it out. So, Not the numbers, not the chart with the numbers on it. It's the article. You got the article. That's it. Johnny, say it. You are it, Johnny. All right. My man. All right. And now this is page. Okay. This is only page. What's page one, Johnny?
That's page one. Okay, well,
page one. Bring the whole thing, Johnny. When stuff like this happens, it just sets me back a little bit. But we're going to get through it. Exodus 38, and we're going to pick it up in verse 21. Go ahead.
This is the sum of the tabernacle, mm-hmm. even of the tabernacle of testimony, mm-hmm. as it was counted, according to the commandment of Moses, for the service of the Levites, mm-hmm. by the hand of Ithamar, son to Aaron the priest.
Now, we're talking about the tabernacle that they had with them in the wilderness. We're not talking about a brick structure or a structure that was permanent. This is one that they took down and put together every time they moved. So we're talking about a major tent. Okay. Now skip down to verse 24.
All the gold that was occupied for the work and all the work of the holy place, mm-hmm. even the gold of the offering, mm-hmm. was 29 talents, uh-huh. and 730 shekels after the shekel of the sanctuary. Mm-hmm. And the silver of them that were numbered of the congregation, mm-hmm. was 100 talents, mm-hmm. and 1,715 shekels, mm-hmm. after the shekel of the sanctuary. Uh-huh. A bekah for every man, mm-hmm. that is half a shekel after the shekel of the sanctuary.
Now, I ain't gonna test y'all on what these things are. I gave everybody a measurement sheet, so we're gonna get through this, and you're gonna understand. We're just gonna deal with the tons and the troy ounces today, because that's we're gonna get that figure so you can see what this total would amount to in today's money. Okay, go ahead.
For everyone that went to be numbered, mm-hmm. from 20 years old and upward, mm-hmm. for 600,000 and 3,550 men.
Now, just imagine each one of these people took a piece of gold out of each. You got 603,550 men. Now, you know they got children and women, right? Because it said the women spoiled the people too, right? Of gold and silver. So just imagine how much stuff got carried out of Egypt by the children of Israel when they left out. Okay? Now you finished that, right? Now we're going to reach page one of this article called The Treasures of the Host, House of the Lord. Page one, this was in 1992. No, that's the first page right there. Oh, yeah. Okay. Go ahead.
Many people in the world today are unaware of the splendor and wealth of ancient Israel. Mm-hmm. In fact, since the destruction of Jerusalem in AD 70, Israel has been scattered among the nations in lowliness and obscurity.
Now, this is an Edomite that wrote this now. But he said they've been scattered in obscurity. They've been scattered. They don't know where they're at. We the ones don't know where we at or who we are. But they try to use that. That's why you know they know something. They can't hide that completely. Okay, go ahead.
The purpose of this essay is to describe briefly the wealth of ancient Israel associated with the mystery of the tabernacle in the wilderness and the temples built in Jerusalem. Mm-hmm. The materials assembled for the tabernacle are described in detail in Exodus 35 to 38, mm-hmm. and summarized in Exodus 38, verse 21 through 30. Mm-hmm. The total quantity of gold collected was approximately 1 ton of silver, mm-hmm. 3 3/4 tons, and of bronze, 2.5 tons.
You missed the one on gold.
No, I didn't.
He's coming up?
Yep.
Okay, good.
At today's prices, gold is approximately $500 per troy ounce.
That was 1992.
Yes.
Today, y'all got a sheet in front of you. We're going to get to it. Go ahead.
Or $6,000 per pound, mm-hmm. or $12 million per ton.
So now, go ahead. You finish up?
Silver currently is priced around $12 per troy ounce, mm-hmm. or $144 per pound, mm-hmm. which is $288,000 per pound. Mm-hmm. Hence, the gold and silver used in the tabernacle of Moses will be worth over $13 million today.
So now, ain't that something? This is just the tent. Now, get your little chart. Everybody should have a chart. It says for gold, 1 ton of gold in today's prices is worth $37 million, right? And then it could say today's gold, a troy ounce is worth $1,300, right? So then you go down to silver, 3.75 tons of silver, today's price would be $1,794,000. You add those two up, you get what? $39,665,000, right? What did they say back then? 56 million?
You said 1992?
Right.
The Tabernacle of Moses?
Right.
13 million.
13 million. So today we are 39 million for a tent. This is just the gold and the silver. I ain't do the brass. No. Right?
Right.
So you just can imagine what the children of Israel had, and they made it themselves. You know where they got that skill from? Being slaves. Sometimes the Lord prepared you for things, even though you didn't know you was being prepared to do his will, right? Because he said, bring everybody with the right heart to do the building of his tabernacle, right? And the people with those skills came, and they did it. And the Lord is a perfectionist. When he said he's going to lay the thing to the plumbing, that means he want to start off accurately. Plain and simple. Okay, so now we're going back to the scripture. Let's go back to the Bible. We're going back to 1 Chronicles, the 22nd chapter. 1 Chronicles 22. And we're going to pick it up at verse 1. 1 Chronicles 22. And verse 1. Because now David getting ready to prepare the temple. Prepare the material for the temple. Okay? 1 Chronicles 22 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Then David said, mm-hmm. this is the house of the Lord God, mm-hmm. and this is the altar of the burnt offering for Israel. Mm-hmm. And David commanded to gather together the strangers that were in the land of Israel, mm-hmm. and he sent masons to hew wrought stones mm-hmm. to build the house of God.
Uh-huh.
And David prepared iron in abundance for the nails for the doors of the gates mm-hmm. and for the joinings, mm-hmm. and brass in abundance without weight.
Mm-hmm.
Also cedar trees in abundance, mm-hmm. for the Sidonians and they of Tyre brought much cedar wood to David.
Mm-hmm.
And David said, Solomon, my son, is young and tender, mm-hmm. and the house that is to be builded for the Lord must be exceeding magnificent.
Now, I love to read that. Exceeding magnificent. You know, we don't use that no more today, right? this house has to be exceeding magnificent. Okay, go ahead.
Of fame and of glory throughout all countries.
Mm-hmm.
I will therefore now make preparation for it.
Mm-hmm.
So David prepared abundantly before his death.
Ain't that something? He even had stone masons come in and cut stone in the right way just to put it together, right? But now, skip down to verse 14. We're going to look at how much other detail he put in. Go ahead.
Now behold, mm-hmm. in my trouble I have prepared for the house of the Lord 100,000 talents of gold,
uh-huh.
and 1,000,000 talents of silver,
mm-hmm.
and of brass and iron without weight,
mm-hmm.
for it is in abundance. Timber also and stone have I prepared,
mm-hmm.
and thou mayest add thereto.
Mm-hmm.
Moreover, there are workmen with thee in abundance,
mm-hmm.
hewers and workers of stone and timber,
mm-hmm.
and all manner of cunning men for every manner of work,
mm-hmm.
of the gold, the silver, and the brass, mm-hmm. and the iron,
mm-hmm.
there is no number.
Uh-huh.
Arise therefore and be doing, mm-hmm. and the Lord be with thee.
Now you let him know, man, I got all the material you need, and it's in abundance. Somehow we can't count, we lost count. We got so much of it. And but because he prepared the temple of the Lord. Okay, go ahead.
David also commanded all the princes of Israel to help Solomon his son, saying,
mm-hmm.
is not the Lord your God with you?
Mm-hmm.
And hath he not given you rest on every side?
Mm-hmm.
For he hath given the inhabitants of the land into mine hand.
Mm-hmm.
And the land is subdued before the Lord, mm-hmm. and before his people.
He said, no, since y'all ain't got to go to war and get killed, the least you can do is put some labor into the temple.
Mm-hmm.
And bring your best. Because your life is on, your life is being saved. Okay, go ahead.
Now set your heart and your soul to seek the Lord your God. Mm-hmm. Arise therefore and build ye the sanctuary of the Lord God. Mm-hmm. To bring the ark of the covenant of the Lord mm-hmm. and the holy vessels of God mm-hmm. into the house that is built to the name of the Lord.
Now, so like I say, David was prepared for this thing. And we saw some big numbers in here of the materials that he brought in. Now let's go to 1 Kings, the third chapter. 1 Kings 3. And we're going to pick it up at verse 5. 1 Kings 3 and verse 5. Now, David just showed you all the materials that he brought. We're going to see what else that Solomon had. 1 Kings 3 and verse 5. Go ahead.
And Gibeon the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream by night. Mm-hmm. And God said, ask what I shall give thee. Mm-hmm. And Solomon said, thou hast shown unto thy servant David, my father, great mercy, mm-hmm. according as he walked before thee in truth, and in righteousness, and in uprightness of heart with thee. Mm-hmm. And thou hast kept for him this great kindness, that thou hast given him a son to sit on his throne, mm-hmm. as it is this day. Uh-huh. And now, O Lord my God, thou hast made thy servant king instead of David my father. Mm-hmm. And I am but a little child. Uh-huh. I know not how to go out or come in. Mm-hmm. And thy servant is in the midst of thy people, which thou hast chosen, mm-hmm. a great people that cannot be numbered nor counted for multitude.
Now, that shows that he understood what being a ruler is, right? And you need to have some understanding in order to rule people in the right way, especially when it comes to serving the Lord at the same time. Okay, go ahead.
Give therefore thy servant an understanding heart to mm-hmm. judge thy people, that I may discern between good and bad. Mm-hmm. For who is able to judge this thy so great a people? Mm-hmm. And the speech pleased the Lord, that Solomon had asked this thing. Mm-hmm. And God said unto him, because thou hast asked this thing, and hast not asked for thyself long life, mm-hmm. neither hast asked riches for thyself, nor hast asked the life of thine enemies, mm-hmm. but hast asked for thyself understanding to discern judgment, mm-hmm. behold, mm-hmm. I have done according to thy words. Uh-huh. Lo, I have given thee a wise and understanding heart, mm-hmm. so that there was none like thee before thee, mm-hmm. neither after thee shall any arise like unto thee.
Now that's a top-notch king. You can't ask for nothing better than that, because he got the wisdom that no man will ever have or ever will be. Okay, but go ahead.
And I have also given thee that without which thou hast not asked, mm-hmm. both riches and honor, mm-hmm. so that there shall not be any among the kings like unto thee all thy days.
Ain't that something? He gave riches anyway. There's enough that David didn't put all this stuff in store. The Lord said he's going to add more to Solomon. Okay, now we're going back to the treasure of the world. And we're going to pick up at page 2. And that's the big section right there. Yeah. Go ahead.
It is known that most or all of the holy vessels of gold and silver from the tabernacle were with the ark when it was brought from the city of David to the first temple by Solomon. Mm-hmm. These materials included 100,000 talents of gold and 1,000,000 talents of silver. Mm-hmm. From his own private fortune, David also gave 3,000 talents of gold and 7,000 talents of high-grade silver. This is an enormous quantity of gold and silver by any standard. 100,000 talents of gold equals 3,750 tons. Mm-hmm. Value today equals $45 billion.
So now, like I said, that was back in 1992, but we're gonna look at it in today's figures. Go ahead.
1,000,000 talents of silver equals 37,500 tons. Mm-hmm. Value of today is $10.8 billion. Mm-hmm. In round numbers, the wealth of the first temple was about $56 billion.
Now, can you imagine that being out there in the middle of nowhere? And that's your God having you build this thing and he's going to make it magnificent? That's one of the seven wonders of the world, right?
Yes.
So when people come by there, they'll be like, what is this? This is something the children of Israel prepared. They weren't running around in no jungle, sticks in their nose. They were a civilized people. Okay, go ahead.
In addition to all the gold and silver, great quantities of bronze, cedar, iron, and precious stones were contributed. Mm-hmm. The most holy place of Solomon's temple was lined with cedar from Lebanon and covered with 600 talents of gold. Mm-hmm. This gold plating alone, about 540,000 troy ounces, will be worth about $270 million today. Mm-hmm. The doors of the temple were also covered with gold plates. During this period of Israel's history, Solomon's income was 666 talents of gold per annum, or about 600,000 troy ounces, worth $300 million today.
Now, ain't that something? That's a nice income for a king, right? You know, and then he didn't have to get voted in. He just took, you know, the Lord chose him. Okay, go ahead.
During the reign of Solomon, silver was as common as stone in Jerusalem. Solomon made 200 massive shields, each 300 shekels in weight, to hang on the walls of his palace. His ivory throne was overlaid with gold. The splendor of Solomon's kingdom brought him recognition and fame that attracted much foreign attention. For example, during her visit to test Solomon with hard questions, the Queen of Sheba brought Solomon 120 talents of gold.
Which now, that's when you come visit, you come visit right. She came with 120 talents of gold? And that's how you come, which is worth what?
Which equals $54 million.
Now, why did she do that? She came to get wisdom from him. And that's a college tuition, but she loved it because she said, what I heard about you ain't even half of what she learned. Okay, go ahead.
And a very great store of spices and precious stones.
Okay, now. So now, we're going to read another part. It's the last page on there. It's got a little light. Yeah, right there with the bottom. I think it's over here. Is that what you're talking about, the Romans?
Yeah. That's the one.
Okay, no. Go to the next one. Get the next one.
Yeah, that's the first one.
Yeah.
This one right here.
Yeah. So now, that temple was built. Now, but go to your chart first before we read that real quick. Just go to the bottom section here. Y'all can go through this and see how it was all added up. Painstakingly work at my ad. To see the total of today's numbers, you'll see the gold that they had, the silver that they had, when they pretty much came up out of Egypt, the gold that David added, the silver that David added, and then the gift that Queen of Sheba added, comes up to $163 trillion in today's money.
Billion.
You know what I'm saying? Is that billion? Billion. Period. Hard, let me read that again so it'll be on tape. Right. $163 billion, rounded. So now that's just to show you that that's what was going on with the temple, right? So now you got these guys over there in the temple now. They got this wall over there and they bobbing their head on it, right? But they saying that that's part of the temple. Read the part right down here. It's not right there. Because now the Lord sent the Romans in to destroy Jerusalem. We're going to see what happened. Okay, go ahead.
Thus, the Roman plunder could well have been worth tens of millions of dollars. The pillaging of the temple, its total destruction, and the burning of Jerusalem with terrible suffering and loss of life occurred in 70 AD under the Roman general Titus.
Now, but he said total destruction of the temple, right? Now, this guy wrote this now. He an Edomite, but they always talk about this wall over there. It's part of the temple. Okay, but go ahead.
Tradition has it that the intense flames of the temple fire melted the gold and silver of the temple so that it ran between the cracks of the rocks. Roman soldiers then totally dismantled the temple stone by stone to extract the gold.
So now, what is that wall over there?
No.
Because we know what the Lord says. So now, let's go to Matthew 24 chapter. Just gonna learn some things on our way to learning some things because when the Romans saw they burned that temple, the gold started spewing out of it. They said, we're gonna tear this place down piece by piece. That means you know the walls had gold in it.
Yeah.
So we didn't even talk about half of the value that you know this thing was. But this is, like I said, this is one of the seven wonders of the world that they don't even have a clue. So by the time they built the second temple, the brothers was over there crying, saying, man, this ain't got nothing compared to the first one Solomon built. Matthew 24. And verse 1. Go ahead.
And Jesus went out and departed from the temple. And his disciples came to him for to show him the buildings of the temple.
Now, you know how Israel is. They get a big old church. They're all happy. Let's see what the Lord going to tell them about this temple. Okay, go ahead.
And Jesus said unto them, see ye not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down.
Ain't that something? Now, that's what we just read. From the Edomite said, wasn't no stone there. And Jesus confirmed it that was going to happen. And now they said over there in Jerusalem that wall is part of the temple.
No.
Has nothing to do with it. I just wanted to clear that up on our way to clearing things up. Because when we built something, that wall would have had gold in it. They'd have been fighting on that wall. But they ain't fighting because there ain't nothing but a gate. That's all it is a gate. Plain and simple. Okay, but now, go to Hosea, the third chapter. Hosea 3. And we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Hosea 3. And verse 1. Because sometimes, you know, it's sad to, you know, to read the Bible and then you see what all we had and then what all we gave up. Knowing we got the true and living God with us, but we decide we're going to be righteous the way we want to be righteous. We're going to do things the way we want to do. And we still have that mentality today. Yeah. Don't tell me what you like it. I'm going to do it the way I like it. Skip what the Lord say. You know? Hosea 3 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Then said the Lord unto me, go yet. Love a woman beloved of her friend, yet an adulteress.
Now, why did the Lord tell him to go get a woman that, like an adulteress? Because that's where Israel is.
That's right.
The Lord is your husband, so he's telling you to go find you a woman just like Israel as a nation. Okay, go ahead.
According to the love of the Lord toward the children of Israel, who look to other gods and love flagons of wine.
Now, what do you mean flagons of wine? Because every doctrine that come up, you want to be a part of. Let's go worship Satan. I'm in. Let's go worship a flower. I'm in. Let's go worship an elephant. I'm in. So he said, you got full of flagons of wine. Okay, go ahead.
So I bought her to me for 15 pieces of silver and for an omer of barley and in half omer of barley. And I said unto her, thou shalt abide for me many days. Thou shalt not play the harlot. And thou shalt not be for another man. So will I also be for thee.
So now he said, look, you stay in the house.
Right.
Don't go running around in the street. Don't go running around no man. And I will take care of you. That's a good husband.
Yeah.
You ain't got to do nothing. Just stay here. And don't, I got to leave for a minute, but don't go running in the street. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
For the children of Israel shall abide many days without a king, and without a prince, and without a sacrifice, and without an image, and without an ephod, and without a teraphim.
So much for Sir Haile Selassie.
Right.
Because they all know he was the king, he's a black king. He ain't no king of Israel. Plain and simple. Okay, because the Lord said we're going to be many days without a king. So when he took out the last three kings, he's the only king that's going to sit on the throne today. From that point forward. Okay, go ahead.
Afterwards shall the children of Israel return and seek the Lord their God and David their king. And shall fear the Lord and his goodness in the latter days.
Now when is that going to happen? In the latter days.
That's right.
When Jesus comes, he's going to set up his throne, and David's going to be your king at that time, right?
Yes, sir.
So is David over Jerusalem now?
No.
So Israel ain't been gathered. And the Lord ain't made his second coming. So we just learned some things on our way, but we're dealing with our kingdom that's going to be set up, and the Lord's going to set it up in the future. And he gonna, but he said, but you're going to be without a king many days. When the last time you had a king? Period. Obama wasn't one of them, I tell you. Yeah. Don't even go there. His dad was a Hamite. Clear, not an Israelite. Plain and simple. Okay, now, you finish that?
Yep.
Now, go to Hosea, the fourth chapter, and pick it up in verse 1. Go ahead.
Hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
For the Lord hath a controversy with the inhabitants of the land, because there is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land. By swearing, and lying, and killing, and stealing, and committing adultery, they break out, and blood touching blood.
That sounds like Chicago, don't it?
Yes.
So, but this was what's going on with the children of Israel within their own land. They killed each other black on black crime, so to speak, right? And the Lord saw that this was happening, because there was no law. Everybody was being unlawful or sinful. Okay, go ahead.
Therefore shall land mourn, and everyone that dwelleth therein shall languish, with the beasts of the field and with the fowls of heaven. Yet the fishes of the sea also shall be taken away. Yet let no man strive, nor reprove another, for thy people are as they that strive with the priests. Therefore thou shalt thou fall in the day, and the prophet also shall fall with thee in the night, and I will destroy thy mother.
So God, Lord said, you strive with the priests? The animals going to suffer because you ain't doing right. They innocent beings, but now you ain't right. The Lord got to destroy the land. Okay, go ahead.
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Well, for what?
Lack of knowledge.
Last thing we want to do is pick up a book.
That's right.
Yeah.
Listen, show me a sign. Show me a movie.
Right.
Show me a picture. But I ain't finna read nothing.
Yeah.
Well, I read the first chapter and the last.
Right.
Right, if I read the whole book. But I know everything. Holy Ghost gonna teach me. That's Israel. Plain as it. Okay, go ahead.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge, mm-hmm. I will also reject thee, uh-huh. that thou shalt be no priest to me. Mm-hmm. Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, mm-hmm. I will also forget thy children.
So that means our children suffering because the parents ain't right. And when the parents ain't right, the Lord just let you go down and down and down. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
As they were increased, mm-hmm. so they sinned against me. Mm-hmm. Therefore will I change their glory into shame. Uh-huh. They eat up the sin of my people, mm-hmm. and they set their heart on their iniquity. Mm-hmm. And there shall be like people, mm-hmm. like priests. Mm-hmm. And I will punish them for their ways, mm-hmm. and reward them their doings.
So now, are we proud as a nation?
No.
We more ashamed, right?
Yes.
Because of what our forefathers did, because if people really knew who we were, they would say, y'all blew the mission. And they would be telling what? The truth. Just that simple. Okay, go ahead.
For they shall eat and not have enough. Uh-huh. They shall commit whoredom and shall not increase. Mm-hmm. Because they have left off to take heed to the Lord. Mm-hmm. Wherefore, and whoredom and wine and new wine take away the heart. Uh-huh. My people ask counsel at their stocks, mm-hmm. and their staff declare unto them. Uh-huh. For the spirit of whoredoms have caused them to err.
Now, what have caused them to err? The spirit of whoredom. They want to be in every doctrine in the world. And they got that spirit on them. Man, I got to preach. Well, you ain't 30 years old. Well, the baby 12 years old, he been preaching since he was 6. He ain't no preacher of the Lord. Right? So if they according to the law, can they preach? No. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
And they have gone a horn from under their God. Mm-hmm. They sacrifice upon the tops of the mountains, mm-hmm. and burn incense upon the hills, mm-hmm. under oaks and poplars and elms, mm-hmm. because the shadow thereof is good. Uh-huh. Therefore your daughters shall commit whoredom, mm-hmm. and your spouses shall commit adultery.
Now who fixed Philip on most of these churches on Sunday? Women. And most of them want to be preachers. Then when they come over here, they can't preach. They say, hey, no, no. Why we can't preach? Because the book say you can't preach. Not Brother Martin, don't blame me. Check that out with the Lord. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
I will not punish your daughters when they commit whoredom, mm-hmm. nor your spouses when they commit adultery. Mm-hmm. For themselves are separated with whores, mm-hmm. and they sacrifice with harlots. Uh-huh. Therefore, the people that doth not understand shall fall.
Ain't that something? Because the Lord wants you to have some knowledge, so you're going to act like you don't understand nothing. What's going to happen? You're going to fall. You can't come to the judging table and say, Lord, I ain't know. Well, you heard it back on February 9th, 2019. So you heard something, right?
Yes.
Now, let's go to Isaiah, the 42nd chapter. Isaiah 42. And we're going to pick it up at verse 18. Isaiah 42. And verse 18. This is the Lord talking to his people. Go ahead.
Hear ye deaf, mm-hmm. and look ye blind, mm-hmm. that ye may see.
Now he called Israel deaf and blind as a nation. Okay, go ahead.
Who is blind but my servant, mm-hmm. or deaf is my messenger that I sent? Mm-hmm. Who is blind as he that is perfect, mm-hmm. and blind as the Lord's servant, mm-hmm. seeing many things but thou observest not, mm-hmm. opening the ears but he heareth not?
Because you be dealing with some people, you be hitting them with cold scripture. And they reading it but they can't hear it. They see it, but can't understand. Can't perceive. The Lord said they deaf and blind. Okay, go ahead.
The Lord is well pleased for his righteousness' sake. Mm-hmm. He will magnify the law, mm-hmm. and make it honorable.
Because now, because people say that law is carnal. So he said he's going to magnify and make it honorable. You better find out what law you're talking about. Because you tell people they ain't got to keep no law, that's the lake of fire by. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
But this is a people robbed and spoiled. Mm-hmm. They are all of them snared in holes, uh-huh. and they are hid in prison houses.
Now, who fill up most of the jails all over the world? Israel. So the ones that call themselves Jews, they ain't in hid no prison house. They ain't even going. They go to jail for embezzlement. You go to jail for crack or marijuana, and you get life. Right? They get embezzlement. They just got to pay a fine. Because we are here in prison now. Okay, go ahead.
They are for a prey, mm-hmm. and none deliver. Uh-huh. For a spoil and none saith, restore.
Now, how you doing? Let me get you out of jail. Let me pay your bond. Yeah. They got people sitting in jail because they can't pay for 2 weeks because they can't pay $100 bond.
They try to change that law here in Chicago now. But it depends on what mail we get. Plain simple. Okay, go ahead.
Who among you will give ear to this? Mm-hmm. Who will hearken and hear for the time to come?
Mm-hmm.
Who gave Jacob for a spoil and Israel to the robbers?
Uh-huh.
Did not the Lord? Mm-hmm. He against whom we have sinned?
No, the man did this to me. It's the Lord that brought the problem. He just used the man to put forth the problem. But it came from the Lord, because can't nobody destroy you that good unless the Lord allow. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
For they would not walk in his ways,
mm-hmm.
neither were they obedient unto his law.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, he hath poured upon him the fury of his anger
mm-hmm.
and the strength of battle.
Mm-hmm.
And it hath set him on fire round about,
mm-hmm.
yet he knew not.
Uh-huh.
And it burned him, yet he laid it not to heart.
We walk around here on fire. And ain't paying no attention while we burn it. Because the Lord struck the match on you. And we don't lay it out. We said, well, that's where it is. You know, and we just accept it rather than try to find out why is this happening. And the preachers ain't telling the people. Because you ain't going to tell me you went to theology school and you didn't read Deuteronomy 28 or Leviticus 26. Because if you only stay in the New Testament, you need to get another degree. Plain and simple. Now, let's go to Isaiah 10. Isaiah 10. And we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Isaiah 10 and verse 1. But just imagine, now, we had the temple. We had, like I say, one of the seven wonders of the world. But we want to do what we want to do. And that's why the Lord took us out. And we went into captivity. Everybody spoiled us. Everybody took a piece of us. And because the Lord allowed. Okay? Isaiah 10 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees,
mm-hmm.
and that right grievousness which they have prescribed,
uh-huh.
to turn aside the needy from judgment,
mm-hmm.
and to take away the right from the poor of my people,
uh-huh.
that widows may be their prey,
mm-hmm.
and that they may rob the fatherless.
Ain't that something? Ain't that what these preachers do? They take advantage of the widow, and they take advantage of the children that don't have a father in the household. No man to lead and guide them, so they take advantage of them. Okay, go ahead.
And what will ye do in the day of visitation,
mm-hmm.
and in the desolation which shall come from far?
Mm-hmm.
To whom will ye flee for help?
Uh-huh.
And where will ye leave your glory?
Mm-hmm.
Without me, they shall bow down under the prisoners,
mm-hmm.
and they shall fall under the slain.
Mm-hmm.
For all this, his anger is not turned away,
mm-hmm.
but his hand is stretched out still.
For all the evil that Israel do, the Lord still does not cast them away. He's still trying to bring them back to him. Okay, go ahead.
Oh, Siri,
mm-hmm.
the rod of mine anger,
mm-hmm.
and the staff in their hand, mm-hmm. is mine indignation.
Now, who's your first captain besides the Egyptians that took Joseph? The Assyrians.
That's right.
They took the first 10 tribes. Okay, go ahead.
I will send him against an hypocritical nation,
mm-hmm.
and against the people of my wrath will I give him a charge,
mm-hmm.
to take the spoil and to take the prey,
mm-hmm.
and to tread them down like the mire of the streets.
Mm-hmm.
Howbeit, he meet him not so,
mm-hmm.
neither doth his heart think so,
mm-hmm.
but it is in his heart to destroy, mm-hmm. and cut off nations, not a few.
So now, because the Lord sent him to destroy nations, right? But not a few. But then the Lord always take back from those nations that took advantage of us. Because he said, though I use you, you know I'm still going to make you pay. He made the Egyptian pay. He made the Assyrian pay. Have you heard anybody be calling himself an Assyrian today? Right? Skip down to verse 10.
As my hand hath found the kingdoms of the idols,
mm-hmm.
and whose graven images did excel them of Jerusalem,
mm-hmm.
and of Samaria,
mm-hmm.
shall I not, as I have done unto Samaria and her idols,
mm-hmm.
so do to Jerusalem and her idols?
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore it shall come to pass,
mm-hmm.
that when the Lord hath performed his whole work upon Mount Zion,
mm-hmm.
and on Jerusalem,
mm-hmm.
I will punish the fruit of the stout heart of the king of Assyria,
mm-hmm.
and the glory of his high looks.
And there's something, because after I let him destroy Israel, I'm going to go and destroy him. Because anybody that do you some damage, the Lord don't forget. Plain and simple. Okay, but now, let's go to Jeremiah, the second chapter. Jeremiah 2. Because just like, you know, today, sometimes you put a gun in somebody's hand, they think they rule the world. But you're supposed to be a protector. You ain't supposed to be the shooter. But their mindset be twisted because they got that authority, and the Lord have to bring them down sometimes. Okay, Jeremiah 2. And verse 4. Go ahead.
Hear ye the word of the Lord, mm-hmm. O house of Jacob, mm-hmm. and all the families of the house of Israel. Mm-hmm. Thus saith the Lord, uh-huh. What iniquity have your fathers found in me, mm-hmm. that they are gone far from me, and have walked after vanity, and are become vain?
That's the Lord asking you, look, I gave you good laws, statutes, gave you all this money, gave you all this goodness, and you're going to go after vain things, after vain God? He said, what did I do to make you turn from me? Okay, but go ahead.
Neither said they, mm-hmm. where is the Lord that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, mm-hmm. that led us through the wilderness, through a land of deserts and of pits, mm-hmm. through a land of drought and of the shadow of death, mm-hmm. through a land that no man passed through, mm-hmm. and where no man dwelt?
Because the Lord even said their shoes didn't get wore out, and their clothes didn't even wax old, because the Lord took care of them. But they don't forgot about him. Okay, go ahead.
And I brought you into a plentiful country, mm-hmm. to eat the fruit thereof and the goodness thereof. Mm-hmm. But when ye entered, ye defiled my land, mm-hmm. and made my heritage an abomination. Mm-hmm. The priest said not, uh-huh. where is the Lord? Mm-hmm. And they that handled the law knew me not. Mm-hmm. The pastors also transgressed against me, mm-hmm. and the prophets prophesied by Baal, mm-hmm. and walked after things that do not profit.
Can you imagine that? You'd have told your child, don't do this, don't do that. And you turn around, they doing exactly what you told them not to do. This is how the Lord is looking at Israel as an adulterous wife, right? Just out there doing things that I told you not to do. Okay, go ahead.
Wherefore, mm-hmm. I will yet plead with you, saith the Lord, mm-hmm. and with your children's children will I plead. Uh-huh. For pass over the isles of Shittim and see, mm-hmm. and send unto Kedar and consider diligently and see if there be such a thing. Mm-hmm. Hath a nation changed their gods, which are yet no gods? Mm-hmm. But my people have changed their glory for that which doth not profit.
Ain't that something? Go look at some of these other nations around the world and see that they still been serving the God they've been serving for the last 5,000 years. They ain't changed their God, which is no God. But Israel, we looking for any kind of God we can serve. A bump on the knee, we can serve him too. Because it don't matter. We just got that horror spirit of religion in our heart, and we won't serve the Lord. Because we ain't talking about no law. And as soon as you walk away from the law, you walk away from the Lord. Just that simple. Okay, go ahead.
Be astonished, O ye heavens, mm-hmm. at this, uh-huh. and be horribly afraid. Mm-hmm. Be ye very desolate, saith the Lord. Mm-hmm. For my people have committed two evils. Mm-hmm. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, mm-hmm. and hewed them out cisterns, mm-hmm. broken cisterns mm-hmm. that can hold no water. Uh-huh. Is Israel a servant?
Yes.
Is he a homeboy slave?
Yes.
Why is he spoiled?
Because he won't listen. If that ain't the scripture that wrote you down or put you in the pocket, I don't know what is. Because the Lord is talking about you as a people, okay? Now, skip down to verse 19.
Thine own wickedness shall correct thee, mm-hmm. and thy backsliding shall reprove thee.
And then so when you get carried off into the ship, you will say, why am I in the ship? Because people say, well, we was in the ship because we was mother. That's why you was on the ship. You stayed with your Lord, you wouldn't have been on the ship. Okay, go ahead.
Know therefore and see that it is an evil thing and bitter, mm-hmm. that thou hast forsaken the Lord thy God, mm-hmm. and that my fear is not in thee, mm-hmm. saith the Lord God of hosts. Uh-huh. For of old time I have broken thy yoke, mm-hmm. and burst thy bands, mm-hmm. and thou saidest, I will not transgress, mm-hmm. when upon every high hill, mm-hmm. and under every green tree, mm-hmm. thou wanderest playing the harlot.
Yeah, because that's what you're going to do, this worship of the God. But you come back to the Lord and say, oh, I'm so sorry, you know. I fell off. I'm going to be back with you. Then you turn around and do the same thing. Just that simple. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, I have planted thee a noble vine, mm-hmm. holy a right seed. Uh-huh. How then art thou turned into the degenerate plant of a strange vine unto me?
Ain't that something? Just like a child that just won't do right. You just say, look, no, I'm done. Get out. Yep. Sooner or later, you got to go. Right? I ain't dealing with you no more. You cost me too much. And the Lord just got fed up with Israel as a nation. Okay, skip down to verse 26.
As the thief is ashamed when he is found, mm-hmm. so is the house of Israel ashamed. Mm-hmm. They, their kings, their princes, and their priests, and their prophets, mm-hmm. said to a stock, thou art my father, mm-hmm. and to a stone, thou hast brought me forth. Uh-huh. For they have turned their back unto me, mm-hmm. and they're not their face. Mm-hmm. But in the time of their trouble, they will say, mm-hmm. arise and save us.
Ain't that something? So when they get in trouble, they don't serve all these other gods. So when they get in trouble, then they won't come back to the true living God. See what the Lord told him. Okay, go ahead.
But where are thy gods that thou hast made thee? Mm-hmm. Let them arise, if they can save thee in the time of trouble.
Yeah, go get that stick you was talking to. Go get that tree you done drug in your house. Pray to them and see if it's going to save you. People think the Lord ain't got no sense. The Lord is smart. And you think you're going to get around him with some sneakiness? He said, go get that God that you've been laying worshiping and let him save you out of your condition. Okay, go ahead.
For according to the number of thy cities mm-hmm. are thy gods, mm-hmm. O Judah. Mm-hmm. Wherefore will ye plead with me? Mm-hmm. Ye all have transgressed against me, saith the Lord. Mm-hmm. In vain have I smitten your children. Mm-hmm. They receive no correction. Mm-hmm. Your own swore have devoured your prophets mm-hmm. like a destroying lion.
Because they don't want to hear no truth.
That's right.
If a preacher come and tell them the truth, you know what they want to do? They want to kill him. Yeah. That's what they did with Jesus, right?
That's right.
Because he came speaking the truth. They said, we got to kill him. Then you might as you do that. They want your life. Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
O generation, mm-hmm. see ye the word of the Lord. Mm-hmm. Have I been a wilderness unto Israel, mm-hmm. a land of darkness? Wherefore say my people, mm-hmm. we are lords. Mm-hmm. We will come no more unto thee. Uh-huh. Could a maid forget her ornaments mm-hmm. or a bride her attire? Mm-hmm. Yet my people have forgotten me days without number. Mm-hmm. Why trimmest thou thy way to seek love? Uh-huh. Therefore hast thou also taught the wicked ones thy ways.
Ain't that something? We worse than the wicked one. And we teaching them to get wickeder. Because Israel can do some con. I just seen them being slick as a snake in the wintertime. They can do some damage on you and make you think like there's something that's really true. But like I said, the Lord said they like foxes in the desert, right? They can always come up with something to trick you. Okay, go ahead.
Also in thy skirts is found the blood of the souls of the poor innocents. Mm-hmm. I have not found it by secret search, mm-hmm. but upon all these. Mm-hmm. Yet thou sayest, mm-hmm. because I am innocent, uh-huh. surely his anger shall turn from me. Mm-hmm. Behold, I will plead with thee because thou sayest, I have not sinned.
Ain't there something? Because you'll find these people all the time. They say, well, I got a good heart. We serve the same God. No, we don't. You serve that other Jesus the Bible talk about. I don't serve him, the one born on December 25th. No, that's another Jesus. That's why the Lord said, you gonna get at you because you say you innocent. Okay, go ahead.
Why gottest thou about so much to change thy way? Mm-hmm. Thou also shalt be ashamed of Egypt, mm-hmm. as thou was ashamed of Assyria.
Now, what does Egypt and Assyria mean to us? Bondage. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. Thou shalt go forth from him, mm-hmm. and thine hands upon thine head. Uh-huh. For the Lord hath rejected thy confidences, mm-hmm. and thou shalt not prosper in them.
Now, why you got your hands on your head? You know the position. Yes, right? You going to captivity. So the Lord just let you know, because you didn't listen to him, even though he made you a kingdom of priests and a holy nation, that he said he had to punish you. Because if he didn't punish you, you're going to get away with it. Drug dealers do the same thing, right? Yeah. You don't pay them, they gonna say, you ain't gonna make no example of me. Because if you don't pay, ain't nobody else gonna pay.
Right, right.
So they go out and beat you up. Lord punish you, because he gotta let you know, if you don't do what he say, you gonna get punished. Just that simple, okay? Now, let's go to Jeremiah the 13th chapter. Jeremiah 13. And we're gonna pick it up in verse 1. Go ahead.
Thus saith the Lord unto me, mm-hmm. go and get thee a linen girdle, mm-hmm. and put it upon thy loins, mm-hmm. and put it not in water. Mm-hmm. So I got a girdle according to the word of the Lord, mm-hmm. and put it on my loins.
I mean, he got this girdle, and he put it around his waist. And that's signifying that the Lord, that's how Israel to the Lord, that's how close you are to the Lord. Okay, go ahead.
And the word of the Lord came unto me that the second time, saying, mm-hmm. take the girdle that thou hast got, mm-hmm. which is upon thy loins, mm-hmm. and arise. Mm-hmm. Go to Euphrates and hide it there in a hole of the rock. Mm-hmm. So I went and hid it by Euphrates as the Lord commanded me. Mm-hmm. And it came to pass after many days, mm-hmm. that the Lord said unto me, arise, mm-hmm. go to Euphrates, and take the girdle from thence, mm-hmm. which I commanded thee to hide there. Uh-huh. Then I went to Euphrates, and did, and took the girdle from the place where I had hid it. Mm-hmm. And behold, the girdle was marred, mm-hmm. it was profitable for nothing.
So now, when he went and dug it back up, he said it was marred and profitable for nothing. And this girdle is representing who? Israel. Okay, go ahead.
Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, mm-hmm. thus saith the Lord, mm-hmm. after this manner will I mar the pride of Judah, mm-hmm. and the great pride of Jerusalem, mm-hmm. this evil people, uh-huh. which refuse to hear my words, mm-hmm. which walk in the imagination of their heart, mm-hmm. and walk after other gods, gods, mm-hmm. to serve them and to worship them, mm-hmm. shall even be as this girdle, mm-hmm. which is good for nothing.
Ain't that something? He said his people are good for nothing. They won't do what he said. So that's why he said he's going to mar them, because they would not follow his law. Okay, go ahead.
For as the girdle cleaveth to the loins of a man, mm-hmm. so have I caused to cleave unto me the whole house of Israel, mm-hmm. and the whole house of Judah, uh-huh. saith the Lord. Mm-hmm. That they might be unto me for a people, mm-hmm. and for a name, mm-hmm. and for a praise, and for a glory, mm-hmm. but they would not hear. Uh-huh. Therefore thou shalt speak unto them this word, mm-hmm. thus saith the Lord God of Israel. Mm-hmm. Every bottle shall be filled with wine, mm-hmm. and they shall say unto thee, mm-hmm. do we not certainly know that every bottle shall be filled with wine, mm-hmm. then shalt thou say unto them, mm-hmm. thus saith the Lord, mm-hmm. behold, I will fill all the inhabitants of this land, mm-hmm. even the kings that sit upon David's throne, mm-hmm. and the priests and the prophets, mm-hmm. and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem, mm-hmm. with drunkenness.
Now, is he talking about wine, literal wine?
No.
He's talking about false doctrine. And we as drunk as I don't know what any other nation on the planet. We got so many churches that we got that zeal, but not according to knowledge, right? Set up churches everywhere. We are just full of drugs. I remember a brother told me one time we was doing a TV shoot for the TV program. He was coming from the south side. He said, man, why all these taverns over here on the west side? I said, what you mean taverns? He said, all these churches over here. All these places of drunkenness. I said, you ain't about lying, bro, but south side just as bad. So it was just funny you said it that way. But that's what the Lord put on Israel, a spirit of drunkenness. Okay, go ahead.
And I will dash them one against another, mm-hmm. even the fathers and the sons together, mm-hmm. saith the Lord. Mm-hmm. I will not pity, mm-hmm. nor spare, nor have mercy, mm-hmm. but destroy them.
Now, ain't that, sometimes I used to tell, when you whooping your child, this hurts me more than it hurts you. But you cannot have no pity. You got to do what you got to do to make them survive, right? Plain and simple. Okay, skip down to verse 18.
Say unto the king and to the queen, mm-hmm. humble yourselves, mm-hmm. sit down. For your principality shall come down, mm-hmm. even the crown of your glory. Mm-hmm. The cities of the south shall be shut up, mm-hmm. and none shall open them. Mm-hmm. Judah shall be carried away captive, all of it. Mm-hmm. It shall be wholly carried away captive.
Yeah, fully carried away captive, right? Anybody getting away? You going through this person. Okay, go ahead.
Lift up your eyes, mm-hmm. and behold them that come from the north. Mm-hmm. Where is the flock that was given thee? Mm-hmm. Thy beautiful flock.
Uh-huh.
What wilt thou say when he shall punish thee? Mm-hmm. For thou hast taught them to be captains and as chief over thee. Mm-hmm. Shall not sorrows take thee, mm-hmm. as a woman in travail? Mm-hmm. And if thou say in thine heart, wherefore come these things upon me? Mm-hmm. For the greatness of thine iniquity are thy skirts discovered, mm-hmm. and thy heels made bare.
Uh-huh.
Can the Ethiopian change his skin, mm-hmm. or the leopard his spots? Uh-huh. Then may ye also do good, mm-hmm. that are accustomed to do evil.
Now, is Israel accustomed to do good? So you know them by their, he said, you know a zebra by his stripes, yeah. right? Israel the same way. They are accustomed to do evil and not to do good. Okay, go ahead.
Therefore will I scatter them as the stubble that passeth away by the wind of the wilderness.
Mm-hmm.
This is thy lot, the portion of thy measures from me, saith the Lord,
mm-hmm.
because thou hast forgotten me and trusted in falsehood.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore will I discover thy skirts upon thy face,
mm-hmm.
that thy shame may appear.
Mm-hmm.
I have seen thine adulteries and thy nans, mm-hmm. the lewdness of thy whoredom, mm-hmm. and thine abominations on the hills in the fields.
Mm-hmm.
Woe unto thee, O Jerusalem,
uh-huh.
wilt thou not be made clean?
Mm-hmm.
When shall it once be?
He said, just one time can you do it right? Just once. And that's a big question with Israel, because you know, you give them like 4 or 5 days, they'll go wrong. Moses was up in the mountain, what, 40 days? After the Lord did all the miracles in Egypt, split the Red Sea, and they come across and say, let's go back to Egypt. Make us a molten calf and say, these be your God, Israel. It don't take long. That's why the Lord said, Kenny, y'all just do right just once. Okay, now, let's go to Jeremiah the 50th chapter. Jeremiah 50. You know, it's some light at the end of the tunnel. We're going to get to it. But like I said, I just show you how, you know, we had the rulership at one time. We had the ability to do the right thing. But we decided, us and our leaders, to do what we wanted to do, rather than follow the Lord. And like I said, he was with them. And they still didn't acknowledge him. Okay? Jeremiah 50. And verse 1. Go ahead.
The word that the Lord spake against Babylon and against the land of the Chaldeans by Jeremiah the prophet. Declare ye among the nations and publish and set up a standard. Publish and conceal not. Say Babylon is taken, Bel is confounded, Merodach is broken in pieces, her idols are confounded, her images are broken in pieces. For out of the north there cometh up a nation against her, which shall make her land desolate, and none shall dwell therein. They shall remove, they shall depart, both man and beast. In those days, and in that time, saith the Lord, the children of Israel shall come, they and the children of Judah together, going and weeping, they shall go and seek the Lord their God.
So, but now, first the Lord got to take the Gentile nation out. That's who Babylon is. Because them the ones that have been whooping on Israel for these last thousands of years. But the Lord come, he's going to return Israel, and Israel going to come weeping after that great tribulation, saying, we want to seek our God now. Okay, go ahead.
They shall ask the way to Zion with their faces thitherward, saying, come, and let us join ourselves to the Lord in a perpetual covenant that shall not be forgotten.
Oh, now you want to go keep the law now. After you got whooped so bad, now you say, okay, yeah, now we know who the God is. Okay, go ahead.
My people have been lost sheep. Their shepherds have caused them to go astray.
Yeah, who are the shepherds? The preachers. Have caused them to go straight. They say, can we do this? Oh, sure, nothing wrong with that. Sure, you can do this, and you can do this. He said the shepherds have caused his people to go astray. Okay, go ahead.
They have turned them away on the mountains. They have gone from mountain to hill. They have forgotten their resting place.
Go ahead.
All that found them have devoured them. And their adversary said, we offend not, because they have sinned against the Lord, the habitation of justice, even the Lord, the hope of their fathers.
So that's why when the strangers say, look, we ain't hurting them. They the ones that hurt themselves, because they turn against their God. We just using them. For slaves and for captives and whatever else we want to do. And think you're going to get away with it. But the Lord said, when you come, Babylon going to have a problem. Okay? Now, go to Hosea, the second chapter. Hosea 2. And we're going to pick it up at verse 14. Hosea 2. And verse 14. Go ahead.
Therefore, behold, I will allure her and bring her into the wilderness and speak comfortably unto her.
Now, this is the second wave after the great tribulation. The Lord going to allure Israel to come to the wilderness. Okay, go ahead.
And I will give her her vineyards from thence and the valley of Achor for a door of hope. And she shall sing there as in the days of her youth and as in the day when she came up out of the land of Egypt. And it shall be at that day, saith the Lord, that thou shalt call me Ishai and shalt call me no more Baalai.
Now, what do you mean Ishai means husband, right? Because now you're going to come back to your man and not be no adulterous one. Okay, go ahead.
For I will take away the names of Baalim out of her mouth, and they shall no more be remembered by their name. And in that day will I make a covenant for them with the beasts of the field, and with the fowls of heaven, and with the creeping things of the ground. And I will break the bow and the sword and the battle out of the earth, and will make them to lie down safely. And I will betroth thee unto me forever. Yea, I will betroth thee unto me in righteousness and in judgment and in loving kindness and in mercy.
Now, because it sounds like the Lord cast his people away. We know in the future he's going to bring his wife back. Okay, go ahead.
I will even betroth thee unto me in faithfulness, and thou shalt know the Lord.
So now that's why they're going to be seeking him this time, right? They're going to be looking for the Lord. Say, show us Zion. Show us what that covenant is. So we want to make a perpetual covenant with him and be his wife. Okay, now. Did you finish that?
Yep.
Now, let's go to Jeremiah 30th chapter. Jeremiah 30. Because Israel got to come back. You can't run from the Lord. You may think you can run, but you can't hide. Jeremiah 30 and verse 7. Go ahead.
Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. For it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off thy neck, and will burst thy bonds, and strangers shall no more serve themselves of him.
Now, you know, because we still in captivity, but we don't know it. But the Lord said he's going to break the yokes off your neck. The one that called themselves Jews, are they going around here acting like captives?
No.
Are they acting like they under some yoke or vine or anything? But you are. Okay, go ahead.
But they shall serve the Lord their God and David their king, whom I will raise up unto them.
Now, that means the resurrection is happening, right? So we know this is future, we know this has not happened. Okay, go ahead.
Therefore, fear thou not, O my servant Jacob, saith the Lord. Neither be dismayed, O Israel. For lo, I will save thee from afar, and thy seed from the land of their captivity. And Jacob shall return, and shall be in rest, and be quiet, and none shall make him afraid. For I am with thee, saith the Lord, to save thee. Though I make a full end of all nations whither I have scattered thee, yet will I not make a full end of thee. But I will correct thee in measure, and will not leave thee altogether unpunished.
Because you're going to go through it. Because you got a company. He said, your own iniquity going to be on you. He's going to prove you. Okay? Now, skip down to verse 16.
Therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured, and all thine adversaries, every one of them, shall go into captivity.
Now, what's going to happen to your enemies? They going to go into captivity. Okay, go ahead.
Shall go into captivity. And they that spoil thee shall be a spoil. And all they that prey upon thee will I give for a prey. For I will restore health unto thee. And I will heal thee of thy wounds, says the Lord.
We're a sick nation, huh?
That's right.
Yes. The Lord said from the head to the toe, we sick. Okay, go ahead.
Because they called thee an outcast, saying, this is Zion, whom no man seeketh after. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring again the captivity of Jacob's tent, and have mercy on his dwelling places, and the city shall be builded upon her own heap, and the palace shall remain after the manner thereof.
So now when you got a palace, you got what? A kingdom, right?
Right.
So the Lord is going to set this thing up, and Israel is going to be the chosen people, okay? Skip down to verse 24.
The fierce anger of the Lord shall not return until he have done it, and until he have performed the intent of his heart. In the latter days ye shall consider.
So now we're talking future, right? We're talking in the latter days. But the Lord going to set this thing up. He said, and his anger ain't going to stop until it's done.
That's right.
The Lord said, sit on my right hand until I make your enemy my footstool. Right. And the Lord said, I've been long waiting for this day. So when he coming with fierce anger. Okay, now, let's go to Jeremiah 31st chapter and pick it up at verse 1. Jeremiah 31 and verse 1. Go ahead.
At the same time, saith the Lord, will I be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus saith the Lord, the people which were left of the swore found grace in the wilderness, even Israel, when I went to cause him to rest. The Lord hath appeared of old unto me, saying, yea, I have loved thee with everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn thee.
So now, he said he had an everlasting love for you, right? He got mad at you, but he said, I'm going to turn away from you and see what your end going to be. And your affliction, you're going to call me early. And then what Israel do, Lord, Lord, help me, help me, help me. Soon they get into a situation, okay? Skip down to verse 8.
Behold, I will bring them from the north country and gather them from the coasts of the earth, and with them the blind and the lame, the woman with child and her that travaileth with child together. A great company shall return thither. They shall come with weeping, and with supplications will I lead them. I will cause them to walk by the rivers of waters in a straight way, wherein they shall not stumble. For I am the father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear the word of the Lord, O ye nations, and declare it in the isles of far off, and say, he that scattered Israel will gather him and keep him as a shepherd doth his flock.
Now, who was going to gather us in the last day? The Lord. Like I said, you got these brothers out here saying in 2019 we're supposed to be going back to the land. I don't know if it's in March or April, but it's going to prove to them to be a liar. And it's coming upon them, so I don't know what they're going to do when that time gets here. But the Lord is going to gather his people. Okay, go ahead.
For the Lord hath redeemed Jacob and ransomed him from the hand of him that was stronger than he.
So now, if somebody is still stronger than you right now, have you been ransomed yet?
No.
So you still got that yoke upon you, right? You still in captivity. So that points to you directly as a people. Okay? Now, let's go to Daniel the 7th chapter. Daniel 7. And we're going to pick it up at verse 13. Daniel 7. And verse 13. Go ahead.
I saw in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven, and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him. And it was given him dominion, and glory, and the kingdom, that all people, nations and languages shall serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion which shall not pass away, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed.
Now, whose kingdom is this? This is the Lord's kingdom, right?
Yes.
So this is what the Lord going to set up in the future on this earth when he comes. Because even in the Lord's Prayer, it says, thy kingdom come. Okay? Skip down to verse 22.
Until the Ancient of Days came, mm-hmm. and judgment was given to the saints of the Most High, mm-hmm. and the time came that the saints possessed the kingdom.
The saints possess what?
Kingdom.
Kingdom. Now, if you want to be a king, you better be a saint.
That's right.
Because if you ain't no saint, you're going to be under the kingdom. And what is that? Lake of Fire. Okay? Skip down to verse 27.
And the kingdom, mm-hmm. and dominion, and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven, mm-hmm. shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High,
uh-huh.
whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, mm-hmm. and all dominion shall serve and obey him.
Now, if we had one of the seven wonders of the world back in the old days, can you imagine what this kingdom going to look like? Because the Lord going to be here, not Solomon. So you can imagine, I can't fathom what that's going to look like, but I know I got a throne. The Lord said, if you do what I say do, I got a throne for you to sit on, right? So I plan on having a seat there. Now, let's go to Revelation 19. Revelation 19. And we're going to pick it up at verse 11. Revelation 19. And verse 11. Go ahead.
And I saw heaven open,
mm-hmm.
and behold, a white horse.
Mm-hmm.
And he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True.
Mm-hmm.
And in righteousness he doth judge and make war.
Now, when is that going to happen? At the coming of the Lord. Okay, go ahead.
His eyes were as a flame of fire,
mm-hmm.
and on his head were many crowns.
Mm-hmm.
And he had a name written that no man knew but he himself.
Mm-hmm.
And he was clothed with the vesture dipped in blood.
Mm-hmm.
And his name is called the Word of God.
Now, he clothed his vesture dipped in blood because he did a lot of killing. Okay, go ahead.
And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses,
mm-hmm.
clothed in fine linen, mm-hmm. white and clean.
Uh-huh.
And out of his mouth forth the sharp sword,
mm-hmm.
that with it he should smite the nations.
Mm-hmm.
And he should rule them with the rod of iron.
Mm-hmm.
And he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God.
Mm-hmm.
And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written,
mm-hmm.
King of Kings, mm-hmm. and Lord of Lords.
Now, King of what?
King of Kings.
So the saints going to be part of the kingdom, right? They're going to be kings too, right?
Yes.
So he's going to be King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Okay? Now, let's go to Isaiah, the 60th chapter. Isaiah 60. Because even though there's going to be other nations there, their king's going to be in there ruling them, but the Lord is going to be King of Kings of Israel and King of Kings of the nation. Okay? Isaiah 60 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Arise, mm-hmm. shine, for thy light is come,
mm-hmm.
and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee.
Mm-hmm.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth,
mm-hmm.
and gross darkness the people.
Uh-huh.
But the Lord shall arise upon thee,
mm-hmm.
and his glory shall be seen upon thee.
Mm-hmm.
And the Gentiles shall come to thy light,
uh-huh.
and kings to the brightness of thy rising.
So now, who going to come to the brightness? The kings, right? Of other nations, because the first resurrection is still going to be flesh on this earth. Okay, go ahead.
Lift up thine eyes round about,
mm-hmm.
and see.
Mm-hmm.
All they gather themselves together.
Mm-hmm.
They come to thee. Thy sons shall come from far,
mm-hmm.
and thy daughters shall be nursed at thy side.
Mm-hmm.
Then thou shalt see and flow together,
mm-hmm.
and thine heart shall fear,
mm-hmm.
and be enlarged,
uh-huh.
because the abundance of the sea shall be converted unto thee.
Mm-hmm.
The forces of the Gentiles shall come unto thee.
So now it's going to come to you in favor this time, not against you. Okay, go ahead.
The multitude of camels shall cover thee,
mm-hmm.
the dromedaries of Midian and Ephah.
Mm-hmm.
All they from Sheba shall come.
Mm-hmm.
They shall bring gold and incense,
mm-hmm.
and they shall show forth the praises of the Lord.
Now, can you imagine just the same way Queen of Sheba brought stuff to Solomon? They're going to be doing the same thing to Israel in the future. Okay, go ahead.
All the flocks of Kedar shall be gathered together unto thee.
Mm-hmm.
The rams of Nebaioth shall minister unto thee.
Mm-hmm.
They shall come up with acceptance on mine altar,
mm-hmm.
and I will glorify the house of my glory.
Mm-hmm.
Who are these that fly as a cloud,
mm-hmm.
and as the doves to their windows?
Uh-huh.
Surely the isles shall wait for me,
mm-hmm.
and the ships of Tarshish first,
mm-hmm.
to bring thy sons from far,
mm-hmm.
their silver and their gold with them.
So now, because when he said, who are these that fly? Because the Lord going to have you delivered in planes. He's going to have you delivered in ships. And you're going to be, what would I say, on the ship this time and not in the ship. Right? And other goods going to be coming with gold and silver. Go ahead.
Unto the name of the Lord thy God, mm-hmm. and to the Holy One of Israel, uh-huh. because he hath glorified thee. Mm-hmm. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, mm-hmm. and their kings shall minister unto thee. Uh-huh. For in my wrath I smote thee, mm-hmm. but in my favor have I had mercy on thee. Uh-huh. Therefore thy gates shall be open continually. Mm-hmm. They shall not be shut day nor night, mm-hmm. that men may bring unto thee the forces of the Gentiles, mm-hmm. and that their kings may be brought. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. For the nation and kingdom that will not serve thee, mm-hmm. shall perish.
Yeah.
Yea, those nations shall be utterly wasted. Mm-hmm. The glory of Lebanon shall come unto thee, mm-hmm. the fir tree, the pine tree, and the box together, mm-hmm. to beautify the place of my sanctuary, mm-hmm. and I will make the place of my feet glorious.
Ain't that something? Because when all these people be bringing all these goods and stuff, don't you know the Lord will have it magnifico then? Because he going to be here. Okay, go ahead.
The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto thee. Mm-hmm. And all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet. Mm-hmm. And they shall call thee the city of the Lord, mm-hmm. the Zion of the Holy One of Israel.
Go ahead.
Whereas mm-hmm. thou hast been forsaken and hated, mm-hmm. so that no man went through thee, mm-hmm. I will make thee an eternal excellency, mm-hmm. a joy of many generations.
Now, ain't that something? So now when you standing by the elevator, ain't nobody going to just skip that floor because they see you finna get on. They ain't going to be scared no more. No matter of fact, they'll be jumping in the elevator now. Ooh, I'm going to take a ride with you. I know I'm safe. But now you know how it is. Now let's go to Isaiah 61st chapter. This will be last. Let's pick it up in verse 1. Go ahead.
The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, mm-hmm. because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. Mm-hmm. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, mm-hmm. to proclaim liberty to the captives, mm-hmm. and the opening of the prison to them that are bound.
Now, who is he talking about? Israel. Well, who is this talking? This is the Lord, right? Okay, go ahead.
To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord, mm-hmm. and the day of vengeance of our God, mm-hmm. to comfort all that mourn, mm-hmm. to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, mm-hmm. to give unto them the beauty for ashes, mm-hmm. the oil of joy for mourning, mm-hmm. the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, mm-hmm. that they might be called trees of righteousness, mm-hmm. the plant of the Lord, mm-hmm. that he might be glorified.
So now, don't think all Israel gonna get in. Because the Lord said he's going to purge out the rebels in the wilderness, right? So that all Israel going to be saved. That's a lie. Because you have to be a saint in order to get into this kingdom. Okay, go ahead.
And they shall build the old ways. Mm-hmm. They shall raise up the former desolations. Mm-hmm. And they shall repair the waste cities, mm-hmm. the desolations of many generations. Mm-hmm. And strangers shall stand and feed your flocks. Mm-hmm. And the sons of the aliens shall be your plowmen and your vine dressers. Mm-hmm. But ye shall be named the priests of the Lord. Mm-hmm. Men shall call you the ministers of our God. Mm-hmm. Ye shall eat the riches of the Gentiles. Mm-hmm. And in their glory shall ye boast yourselves. Mm-hmm. For your shame, ye shall have double.
So now, ain't that something for all the stuff we went through? Now we're going to get double back. So all that stuff you did, just say, look, I'm getting double back. So it'd be worth, worthy of the suffering, because the more you suffer, the more you're going to get back. Okay, go ahead.
And for confusion, mm-hmm. they shall rejoice in their portion. Mm-hmm. Therefore, in their land, they shall possess the double. Mm-hmm. Everlasting joy shall be unto them. Mm-hmm. For I, the Lord, love judgment. Mm-hmm. I hate robbery for burnt offering, mm-hmm. and I will direct their work in truth, mm-hmm. and I will make an everlasting covenant with them.
We keep getting on back to that covenant, right? So is the Lord going to be in the kingdom when the Lord get here? Yes, it will. Okay, go ahead.
And their seed shall be known among the Gentiles, mm-hmm. and their offspring among the people. Mm-hmm. All that see them shall acknowledge them, mm-hmm. that they are the seed which the Lord hath blessed.
Ain't that something? Well, this is a totally different kingdom, man. Now all of a sudden they're gonna be knowing you instead of putting you down or trying to get away from you. You know, like when you move in the neighborhood, everybody started getting out. Now they're gonna be trying to live next door to you. And then feed your flocks, take care of your children. That's when you know you're in the right kingdom. But that's the kingdom that the Lord is gonna set up for all his saints. So even the strangers can be saints. And they can make it in and get a portion as well. But you better be a saint. Ain't no wicked people getting to this kingdom because the Lord threw Satan out of heaven, right? And that's why he said, thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. You don't do it right, you're going to get kicked out. Just that simple. So that's the lesson. When we were kings, I hope somebody got some understanding. I thank you very much.
Yeah, you got to have it up there.